Nearly 40 Australians have made it home on board a mercy flight from Nepal. Their travel insurer tracked them down in remote parts of the country and chartered a jet to bring them back.
Mitch Morley has dreamed of this moment since the Nepal earthquake hit as he and a group of Australians headed for base camp at Everest. They worked with Australian embassy officials to locate and bring to Kathmandu 38 travellers.
The last post for me is one of the most remarkable sounds I've ever heard. It was first played in the 18th century as a way of letting soldiers know that the fighting was over and it was time to follow that sound back home. We're in Kathmandu and our team is getting ready to begin its 10-day trek. We're planning to fly to Lukla and then walk those 10 days to base camp and commemorate Anzac Day. And what's special about that? Is that we'll be celebrating 100 years since the troops first landed at Gallipoli shores. This promises to be a truly remarkable experience and something that we will take home and remember forever. Please join us on this remarkable journey. This is our story.
Decided to come to Base Camp Everest for our dawn service because of my grandfather who served in World War II at Kokoda. I've decided to bring a photo of him when he was in the war, and I also brought his service medals. So yeah, I'm really excited about this and can't wait to get up there and have a dawn service. It'll be very special for the whole team.
To celebrate the 100th anniversary of the Anzacs at Everest Base Camp will be something really special. I always take the somber moment to remember those who have gone before us and who still lie on foreign soil, and also those guys, friends of mine, who have not made it through their military service, to remember them in quiet contemplation, and also my brother, who's no longer with us, but served 12 years in the Australian Navy and saw some things he didn't want to see. To remember those sort of people in the quiet surrounds of Everest Base Camp, I think it'll be just absolutely superb and something that I'll treasure for the rest of my life.
I guess the main reason I came to the Himalayas was because it was a part of the world that I've always wanted to see, but also my father, who is one of the guides on this trek, he was in the army and he's celebrating the 100th Gallipoli anniversary, the Anzacs, and I thought it'd be a good thing for me to come with him, and I want to celebrate that too.
Okay, well here we are, day four, Namchar Bazaar. The team's moving up the trail really, really well, encompassing everything that the ANZAC spirit is about. Strength, honour, courage, mateship, endurance, and we're really, really looking forward to the next few days.
So much fun. Great day. Love this place. Did she say fun? She's suffering a little altitude sickness at the moment. What she meant was really tough but really cool.
Fear what you found. When the weather comes on, tearing down. There'll be oats in the water.
It's an early morning start in this traditional village called Portsi, high in the Himalaya. The days are settling into a regular pattern of 6 o'clock wake up, 6:30 breakfast, and 7 o'clock on the track. And the great advantage of that, of course, is that we wake up to see these absolutely spectacular views.
This morning, so this has been our first uphill. Bit of huffing, bit of puffing, sucking in a few deep breaths, but once you get to the top, it's magnificent. And the view from here is just absolutely stunning. 360 degrees mountains with snow. Fantastic.
Oh, I'm feeling good. We've just made it up to a 5-2 on the way to Gorkha. The team's going well. We've all just made it up to 5-2. We're all feeling very proud of ourselves. Now I've nearly made it all the way to base camp. Not long to go. Today's the day, so not long to go, and we're feeling very proud. So yeah.
Is rising over Lobache, our highest point so far on the trip at just under 5,000 metres, and just 2 days away from our Remembrance Day ceremony. It's almost impossible to imagine what was going through the minds of those young Australian and New Zealand soldiers as they were sitting in those steel hulks in the Dardanelles waiting to disembark and land on the shores of Gallipoli almost 100 years ago to this day. 8 months later, and that disastrous campaign was over with a loss of 8,000 Australian lives, nearly 3,000 New Zealand lives, and an incredible 85,000 Turkish lives.
Elijah Percy Titchener, who was part of the Australian Imperial Forces 1914 to 1918 and served on the Western Front in Gallipoli. And to my father, Trevor Lang Francis Titchener, who served in the New Zealand Navy 1942 to 1944.
Thanks, Lee. Thanks for your service, boys.
ANZAC Day, 100 years to the day in which troops first landed on the shores of Gallipoli. And rather than hold the ceremony at base camp, we all thought how great it would be to find a place that we could in fact call our own. And so this place, this now sacred place marked by those stones behind me, will forever be known as ANZAC Hill. A hell of a lot has happened since our dawn ANZAC service yesterday. Just north of Kathmandu was the epicentre of an 8.8 Richter scale earthquake that we have now found out has devastated the city and resulted in 3,000 deaths. The shockwaves were felt all the way up to Mount Everest Base Camp, where we'd been not 24 hours beforehand, resulting in a gigantic avalanche that took half of Mount Pamuri and spread it right through the centre of Everest Base Camp, resulting in what we now know to be at least 13 deaths. We're now at Namche, in what's quickly shaping up to be a refugee camp for all the locals, trekkers from up the track, and a variety of other people who, quite frankly, are too scared to sleep in their houses tonight. Because over the last 12 hours, there have been multiple aftershocks.
The planes are coming into Lukla now, thick and fast. And for the first time in the last couple of days since the first of the earthquake struck, our team, I think, can afford to be somewhat optimistic. It looks like, I really, really hope, it looks like we'll be able to be airlifted out of Lukla and make our way to Kathmandu. God only knows what we're going to experience there. But at least we're one step closer to our friends, our families, and our loved ones.
I've never met such generous, kind-hearted human beings who, under extreme circumstances, still open their hearts to us, complete strangers. Some of the people that we've come across have lost their homes, and yet they put a tent up to feed people for free. Porters going up and down the mountains with extreme weights on their backs will always stop and say namaste to you if you say namaste to them.
This trip's been significant for me on a number of levels. A personal journey that I've wanted to embark on for a long time. I feel a strong connection to Tibetan Buddhism, the people of this area, the Tibetan culture. So to be able to trek, to challenge myself on such an adventure has been a dream come true.
on these roads with ugly minds of noon. Holding on to things from which we had thought we've grown. Holding on to things from which we knew, but now we're lost. So when you walk your demons tonight, let's all let pause and we'll keep them warm and we'll keep them warm. So follow the ocean back to your heart, follow your fears back to the stars. Follow the ocean back to your heart, follow your fears back to where we learned and where we were taught to fit this falling, falling. This falling for you.
I've never done anything like this before. It's been a challenge mentally and physically to get through it. There were some times I thought, this is it, I'm giving up, but I just pushed through. So yeah, it's been great experience for me. And the one driving force for me is to get home to see Bronwyn. Because I know she's pretty upset at home after all what's happened. But yeah, this has been fantastic. Yeah, so, yeah.
So follow the ocean back to your heart, follow your fears back to the stars. Follow the ocean back to your heart, follow your fears.
By the end of today, we will all be on our flights back home to our friends and family. It has been a most remarkable trip, and I gotta say, without the full support of Peak Potential, none of us would be here right now getting ready to go home.
Coming home, 'cause I'm not sure.